All right, what's up, everybody? So I've literally spent the last like 5 or 6 hours just like messing around with stuff. I also wrote a script for everyone to use. It's gonna take care of a lot of the optimizations. But there's still some stuff I'm gonna do. But this is a clean Windows install. So I'll start off with basically, this is the script I wrote. So I will put a Google Drive link in the info section under the video. But basically, so I'm going to put a Google Drive link. You're going to download it. Just put it on your desktop, whatever. Doesn't matter. You're going to open it, and it's going to open up a notepad like this. And basically, okay, well, actually, let me preface it with this. You're going to want to go into recovery. Where is it? Okay, so we're going to go to Advanced System Settings, go to Startup and Recovery Settings. I lied. System Protection. Sorry, Jesus Christ. So, yeah, we're going to come in here. You're going to click Create. You're going to make one. Just type it like pre-Sparty Optimizations. And click Create. It might not let me do it because I just created one right before. You can only make a certain amount, like in a day or something. I don't know, whatever. But it let me make it anyway. So basically, what you're gonna do is if this script or some shit you do messes up your PC, if you accidentally do something wrong, you can come back here to System Protection, System Restore, and then you go choose a different restore point, and then you just click on the one that you made, click Next, go through that. It'll reverse all the settings that you did. So back to this. Basically, you're gonna open this, and then you're gonna open up PowerShell. Or you're going to type in PowerShell, you're going to right-click on it, run as admin, and then basically you're just going to go select all, copy, and then you're going to paste it in here, and then it's going to do a bunch of shit. I'm not going to do it because I already did it like a couple seconds ago. I probably should have just done that on the recording, but basically, yeah, you just let it do its thing. It's going to install a bunch of stuff, change a lot of settings. So that's the biggest thing. That'll mess around with some stuff in your registry. It's going to mess around with some Windows stuff, but we're just going to go through some other settings. I'm just going to basically run through this, make sure everything is done the way I want it. So for display, going to go, if you're on Windows 11, make sure you go to graphics settings and turn on hardware acceleration. Some Windows 10 PCs have it as well. Mine does not. Obviously, go into your advanced display, make sure your refresh rate's up the highest it can be. So next, I'm going to go sound control panel. I'm going to disable any devices that I'm not using. The more audio devices you have, the more input latency it will cause. This is my gaming PC, so the only thing I need is my optical port, and then I have an aux cord going from my Go XLR to here to be able to use game chat and whatnot. But basically, yeah, just go. I would disable everything you're not using. And then we can head over to notifications. I'm not sure why the script doesn't turn that off automatically, but whatever. Just turn that off. Notifications are annoying as shit. You could leave focus assist off. It doesn't really matter because if you have notifications off, you shouldn't get anything anyway. So power and sleep, we're going to head over here. Make sure you're on high performance. Go to change advanced power settings. So the script should change some of these for you. If it doesn't, just copy mine. So make sure turn hard disk is set to 0. Then we're going to go desktop background settings. Turn slideshow to paused. Wireless adapter doesn't really matter unless you're on a laptop. If you're on a laptop, I would set this to max performance. But set that. When you're on a laptop, it should say while on battery or while plugged in. Make sure while on battery, it's put that to like power saving, but while plugged in, it should be max performance. Sleep, pretty much just make sure that this is sleep, never hibernate, never. Don't really know what hybrid sleep does. We're just going to turn that off. USB settings, make sure selective suspend is set to disabled. So you can leave all this the way it is, and then apply. Good. So should be good there. So come over to choose what the power buttons do. Click change settings, and then make sure turn on fast startup is off. Good there, I think. So notifications off, power and sleep. Focus assist, storage. So under storage, go to optimize drives. Make sure you optimize your SSD. If you don't have an SSD, I highly recommend getting one because drives are just not good, especially with how cheap SSDs are now. I personally turn scheduling off because I just do this manually. I do this like once every couple of days. So do that. Can get rid of any temporary files, previous Windows installations. Make sure I don't have anything in my downloads folder that I need. Actually, I think I do. Yeah, my chipset drivers. I'll explain that in... Oh, wait. All right, so... The rest, I don't... much can remove all of this. I'm going to remove some space. This is definitely going to be good if you're on an older Windows install. Like I said, I'm starting from scratch, basically. So you can turn on storage sense. I don't. Like I said, I just kind of go through and disable things myself. Tablet, make sure this is set to never use tablet mode. Multitasking, I don't use snap windows. Projecting to the PC, this should be offed. This should be off automatically with the script that I gave you. Same thing here, same thing here, same thing here. Should be good in here. So head over to devices. What I'll do is I'll say go to device manager. Make sure the script should have turned this off or disabled it. Make sure you go to system devices, right click on high precision event timer, disable that. Make sure you're also going into your mouse and keyboard and mouse, keyboard, or Xbox controller, whatever you're using. Go to it, go to power management. Make sure this is unchecked. I also like to do that for all of my USB ports. Personally, basically make sure, because like it'll try to save power by essentially turning off USB ports. So I just essentially turn that feature off. I think that's all. And for me, I'm going to turn off. I don't, if you're using an AMD GPU or an NVIDIA GPU, a lot of times it'll say high definition audio device, like, or it'll say like NVIDIA or AMD streaming audio device. This is basically your HDMI audio, at least the high definition one is. I'm not sure about streaming. My high definition audio device, I have to leave that on for my optical port. If you're using an output, like a Go XLR, an Astro Mix Amp, or anything of that nature, you probably don't need the high definition stuff. I would recommend turning that off. If you have Adrenalin installed for AMD, disable dynamic audio noise suppression. You don't need that. You can go to your Ethernet adapter, make sure power management, that's turned off as well. So I think we're good here. Go phone, there shouldn't be anything. Network, the script should have taken care of that. So personalization, I'd like to do the background into a solid color. I just do black. I don't turn transparency effects on. You can change the accent color if you want. I don't really think it matters. Like, you can do that, you can do this. I mean, I don't like the way that looks, but the title bars and the window borders looks kind of nice. Lock screen, I pretty much just, I mean, I don't have a user and password. It pretty much just brings me right to the desktop when I log in, so don't have to worry about that. It's kind of all preference. Go over to apps. I haven't installed the chipset drivers yet, but I basically just go through all this, and I'm not sure why the script didn't get rid of a lot of this, but I'm just gonna go through all this and uninstall a bunch of nonsense. When you install Google Chrome, it adds this. It really does too much, but And get rid of this stuff. If you're using Steam, you can... I wouldn't recommend getting rid of the Xbox stuff. Assuming you're playing Halo Infinite. If you're not playing Halo Infinite, then you could essentially kind of get rid of all the Xbox stuff. But for Halo Infinite, I wouldn't recommend it. Microsoft Edge. I can actually show you guys how to get rid of Edge. It's a like it's really easy with the script, but without a script, it's actually a fucking pain in the ass. They really don't want you to get rid of Edge. I think Edge is dog shit. I use Chrome, even though Chrome eats up your CPU usage. I just like the way Chrome is. So like I said, I'm just going to basically go through here, uninstall all this nonsense. The less processes on the computer, the better. Also, I have a different computer, so a lot of this stuff I would just do on my other computer. I'm pretty much just using this solely for gaming. I use sticky notes on my other computer. I won't use it on this. Should be pretty much good here. This stuff should be turned off. Make sure, go to the startup tab and just turn all this shit off. Also, I'm going to go real quick. I mean, I'll run into it later, but go background apps. This should be turned off from the script as well. So, just double check. We'll go into gaming. Make sure this game bar crap is off. If you want to like record clips and stuff, I would just recommend if you're on NVIDIA, just use GeForce Experience, even though I feel like any overlays you use are going to be, I don't know, it's just going to add input latency. I would just recommend either recording with like OBS if your computer can handle that while gaming, or using another computer with either a capture card or NDI. I personally use two PCs and I use NDI. I can show you guys that towards the end of the video if you want. So going through all these, make sure it's basically this stuff should be all fine, should be off. That stuff doesn't matter too much. So gonna check for updates. The script is gonna basically make it so that it won't, it'll check for updates, but it won't install them automatically. It'll only install like Windows Defender updates. So that's the end of that. So now I'm gonna go system configuration. So I'm gonna go into boot. I would recommend putting your stuff to, depending on how good, like the better your computer is, the more it can handle. So this computer is pretty solid. I'm going to do no GUI boot, 3 timeout, and then I'm going to go into advanced and I'm going to turn the number of processors to the maximum amount that I have. I would recommend doing this. If you're on a lower end PC, put your timeout at like 10 seconds, but I would still recommend doing the no GUI boot and number of processors, make sure that's good. And apply that, press OK, and then it's going to tell you that you need to restart. We'll do that after. Let's go advanced system settings, go performance, go to adjust for best performance. I would do smooth edges of screen fonts and show thumbnails instead of icons. We're going to apply that. Virtual memory, I would essentially just go here, system manage sized, set, press OK. It's going to tell you need to restart. Fine. I don't believe we need to do anything else in here. Good. But we're going to go services. So some of the services are going to be automatically disabled from the script that I gave you, but some of them you can still disable that might still be running. So I'm just going to run through real quick. You're definitely going to want to make sure. So this should be disabled. Connected user experience and telemetry. Make sure that's disabled if it's not for some reason. Come down to... So, I personally don't see a reason to have diagnostics running. I don't care about sending my info to Microsoft. Downloaded Maps Manager, make sure that's disabled. So the script should have basically disabled game DVR and broadcaster user service. It's going to say manual here, but it should have disabled it in the registry. So geolocation service, make sure that's disabled. Make sure that when you, like, if this is running, for instance, click on this, change this to disabled, apply, and then click stop as well. I mean, if you restart the computer, it's going to be disabled anyway, but if you're going to keep running after all this, then you want to make sure you stop it. IP helper, if you're not using IPv6 for any reason, just disable it. You don't need to worry about that. Going down. Honestly, it'd probably be easier if we just go by running. Make sure, we don't need print spooler if we're gaming. I mean, if you're using a printer for anything, then don't disable that. Like I said, this PC I'm on is solely for gaming. I do nothing else on it. If you're, like, using it for, like, school and stuff like that, do not turn that off. Assuming you print stuff. Secondary logon, you don't really need this if you only have one user account on the PC. So, if you only have, I have just me, like, just Tyler on this computer, so if you only have one person, then you can get rid of that. Should be good here. I say the only one I would double check is Windows Biometric Service. Windows Biometric Service, mine's disabled. Just make sure that yours is disabled and not running. So, good there. Now, I'm going to go into the registry, but everything should have been done for you, essentially. This is going to change the priority of your GPU compared to everything else on the computer, and it's also going to change the priority of any games you're playing. So, if you want to, I'm going to basically just go back to the start. This is what it's going to look like when you open the registry for the first time. So, you're going to open HK Local Machine, Software, Microsoft, and then you're going to come down to Windows NT, and you're going to go down to Multimedia, and you're going to basically System Profile, Tasks. So you're going to click on System Profile. Make sure this is what it looks like. The script should have changed it to this for you guys automatically. If for some reason it didn't, you're just going to double click on this. You're going to put in 8 zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay. And then for network throttling, it's going to be 8 Fs, 1, 2, 3, not capitals. Like I said, make sure you don't fuck anything up in the registry. If you do, you're going to need the restore point or your shit might just get chalked. Be very careful in the registry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then after you do that, it should automatically set to this number. And then you're going to come down to games. Make sure this is what it looks like. So GPU priority generally is already set to 8. The priority is usually set to 2. So you want to change that to 6. If it's not, like I said, the script should do all of this for you guys. I would essentially just double check. That's the biggest part. Now, you could go here. Let me see if I can remember it off the top of my head. I don't know if I do. Okay, yeah, so, I mean, I'm probably going to have to fucking change my IP after this so I don't get hit offline, but essentially, it's going to be a folder that looks like this. It's going to have all these options. This is what it should look like after you run the script. It should say TPC or TCP ACK frequency, TCP no delay, and both of them should be set to 1. That's going to disable what's called Nagle's algorithm. If you want to know more about it, it's a networking thing. I would just Google it. So that's pretty much it. Now, what I'll do two more things in this video. Actually, I mean, I guess I could do a couple. So first thing, this is what I do with my Adrenalin. If you're on an AMD GPU, coming to Adrenalin, I would go to the settings tab, check for updates, turn that off, issue detection off, go over to preferences, make sure you turn in-game overlay off. I leave the system tray on, so that way when I close it, it stays in the task, or it, like, stays in the system tray. The reason I do that is because I do tuning in here, and I would say that if you're just a gamer who's staying at home, don't use Adrenalin. I would learn how to do all this stuff in the BIOS so that it saves permanently, and because generally any program that's changing the way that the GPU and the CPU works, it's not going to save properly. So I would make sure that if I essentially, this is what I do at tournaments, to overclock the GPU. Like I said, if you're, okay, I hate it when it does this. I don't know why I was having this issue with Adrenalin before, but, so I just do this at tournaments because it's easy to do. But if you're, like I said, if you're not competing or anything, or you're just playing online, or you're just playing at home, I would learn how to do this stuff with, like, Afterburner, like, MSI Afterburner in the BIOS, that kind of stuff. But basically, this is what I do at tournaments. So, at tournaments, what I do is I come into the tuning tab. AMD Smart Access Memory should be enabled. If it's not, you have to go into your BIOS and make sure that 4G decoding is enabled, and then resize bar is enabled. And then this will be able to be enabled. So, what I do is I go into custom for the GPU, and I essentially just overclock the fuck out of everything. And I also set pretty aggressive fan curves. I mean, you don't need to at home because it's probably not going to get near as hot. I just do it anyway. But at tournaments, I mean, it's hot as fuck. There's like 30 PCs running, a bajillion people. The venue gets hot, and the PCs overheat, and then HGS wonders why we're crashing 37 fucking times a day. So I set pretty aggressive fan curves so that way my GPU temp stays really low. Like I said, I would recommend doing this with Afterburner or in your BIOS and not Adrenalin, but if you're a competitor like me, just do it like this because you can do it at tournaments. It's easy to set up. As for your GPU frequencies, when it comes to overclocking, every GPU is different. Also, if you're on a more powerful GPU, you can probably get away with doing a higher megahertz. You can also probably get away with undervolting to keep the temperature down. For a while, I was just kind of undervolting this down to like 1100. It keeps the GPU a little bit cooler and does the same job. Memory timing, I'll set that to fast because I'm basically just overclocking the VRAM. I mean, I don't really know if I need to be. I just kind of do it anyway. For me, it just makes the game feel better. But, so that's what it looks like for my Adrenalin. I'm going to make a profile so that way if I ever need to import the settings, like sometimes you'll launch Adrenalin and the settings won't be there. So I'll essentially just I'll go to import, click this, open, proceed, whatever. It sets the settings for me. Bam, done. But I'm going to go over to gaming. I'm going to go to display. Make sure that FreeSync is off. You do not want to be playing with FreeSync or G-Sync or any of that bullshit. It's going to make the game feel horrible. So depending on like how good your PC is, if you're on a lower end PC, anti-lag is good. If you're on a higher end PC, it's not really. But I set texture filtering to performance. I turn surface format off. I override the tessellation, turn that off. And then, let's see if I can add the game. I can add Halo Infinite. I might just have to launch it, but. Okay. Yeah. Launch it. Oh, that's not what I want. Xbox app. I just want the Xbox app. That's it. Did I not install it? I could have swore I installed apps. Ooh. It's right there. Pain in the ass. I'm just going to go here. Create a desktop shortcut. Okay. That. Just launch this so the game shows up in Adrenalin. Do this. Allow that. Okay, so now it's in Adrenalin. I'm going to go in here. I always make sure this is set to off. FreeSync off. No bueno. Even if my monitor is not FreeSync compatible, I don't care. I just don't even want to imagine it somehow being a thing. That's the head case in me. But that's basically it. I just go in here and turn that off. So I think that's good for the AMD part of things. What I'll do is I'll switch over to my gaming PC, show you guys what I would do in NVIDIA Control Panel. And then I'll also show you guys how to set up NDI if you're using two PCs. And then that should be it. While the game's loading on this PC, I'm going to switch over. Add a display capture. Is second. This is my streaming PC, or my second PC, whatever. So, if you're on an NVIDIA card, what I would do is first go to manage 3D settings. So, VSync, turn that shit off. Threaded optimization, turn that on. Texture filtering, where it says quality, make a high performance. Then head up to preferred refresh rate, highest available. Power management mode, prefer max performance. And then for monitor technology, I would just recommend staying at a fixed refresh. I do not recommend using G-Sync or FreeSync or any of that. Especially if you're on a higher end PC. If you're on a lower end PC, they can be helpful, but just keep in mind whenever you're using FreeSync, G-Sync, fucking anything of that nature, you're increasing your input delay. It's gonna, like, it's just naturally gonna feel worse. So like I said, fixed refresh, max and prefer performance. Highest available, texture quality or performance, threaded optimization on, vertical sync off. So that's what I would make it look like for your 3D settings in here. You can go to, one thing I like to do personally on NVIDIA is I like to go to, where is it? Adjust desktop. Color settings, I'll turn my digital vibrance up to 75. That's just preference. But like I said, I don't use G-Sync, especially on a computer like this. I have a fucking 13900KS with a 4090. There's just no point. I don't think anything sync is ever good for input latency purposes. So should be good there. Now for NDI. So essentially, what NDI is, if you want a dual PC stream or record or anything of that nature, and the reason I do this is because when you use capture cards to dual PC stream, you get really bad input delay. I tried to fix it. This was like 7 or 8 months ago. I couldn't find a fix for it. It felt terrible. So I ended up going back to single PC streaming, but then I ended up going back to this to use two PCs. So I'm going to show you, I'm going to go back to my gaming PC where Halo is currently loading. Going to go, I need to download OBS Studio. Let's see, Studio. Here, Windows. Load that. We're going to go Google NDI. Okay, well, NDI OBS. Okay, first off, let me go into the game and turn off the freaking music real quick. Audio. All right, music. Good. I'll come back to the game later or whatever. So I'm going to go here to OBS NDI. Going to go to this GitHub link. So first, let me install OBS. I'm just going to launch OBS, and I'm just going to say optimize for streaming for that later. All right, so I'm just going to close this out now. Okay, so NDI, I'm going to go to this GitHub link, github.com/OBS-NDI/OBS-NDI. So then first thing you're going to do is, obviously, depending on the operating system, I'm assuming if you're watching this video, you're on Windows. So click this first link. It's the installer. And then after that, you're going to come down here, copy the Windows link, and put that here. And it's going to download NDI 5 runtime. So the first thing we're going to do is open the NDI Windows installer. Next, next, next. This is just installing it as an extension on OBS. And then NDI 5 runtime. This is installing the actual back end of it. So going to install that. Bam, done. All right, so now I'll set up NDI. This to my taskbar, give me a sec. All right, so done there. So now essentially all you have to do is whenever you're gaming, you just leave OBS running, but you're not actually streaming, so you're not using very many resources. We're going to come up to tools, NDI output settings. We're going to check, doesn't really matter, I just use preview output. I'll type in Ty's gaming PC. And okay, so then you just add your sources. So I'm just going to add a game capture. Let me open up Halo now. Now I'm just going to open this, go back. I'm going to come game capture. Type in Halo, it doesn't really matter. You don't have to do anything if you don't want to. Limit the capture frame rate, so that way it keeps the capturing frame rate at 60. Capture cursor, you can, doesn't matter. I personally just this is just how I set it up. I do specific window, Halo Infinite, match title, otherwise find window, same executable. So okay, bam, done there. Now I'm just gonna disable the preview because it doesn't use any resources. It uses less resources when you disable the preview. So I'm just gonna I'm gonna minimize this. Now keep in mind I'm using a Go XLR. So getting audio from my game PC to my stream PC is way easier. If you're gonna try to dual PC stream without a Go XLR, I cannot help you. I would look up tutorials on how to use Voice Meter Banana. I can't help you there though. So this is solely just to get basically the screen, what's on the screen, over to my gaming PC. So now I'm going to minimize this. I'm going to come back over to my stream PC. And then, so I'm going to turn the capture card off. And now we're back in where you guys can see my desktop. I'm going to full screen this. Now I would come in here and I would click add NDI source. You have to, so essentially how I installed OBS and NDI on my gaming PC, you do the same on the streaming PC. So after you do the same exact thing on both PCs, you would just, you don't need to worry about NDI output settings on the on the computer that's coming in. So you would just come here, NDI source, and then just type in like gaming PC, okay, gaming PC, NDI. I think the other one's my capture card. So source name, you should be able to see the one that you originally set. Like I said, I set Ty's gaming PC. I do bandwidth highest, sync. I don't really know what each of these settings do. I typically just leave them all default, but there you go, bam. So essentially NDI is like, it's like you're streaming from one computer to the other through your network, but you're not actually like using resources or streaming. So now if we go full screen, so like I have I'm capturing twice right now for my gaming PC. So gaming PC here, this is actually my Elgato. And then this part is the NDI. So that's how I do all that. Now That's just about everything I can think of, guys. Windows 11 has some extra debloat you can look into. Pretty much everything I did was Windows 10. Keep in mind, these are the PCs that we play on at tournaments. It's an AMD 5800X. The GPU is an AMD 6800 XT. The motherboard is an X570 Dark Hero. There's 32 gigs of RAM. I would definitely make sure that for anybody, go into your BIOS, make sure resize bar is on. Make sure that if you're using an Intel CPU, turn on XMP. If you're using an AMD CPU, turn on DOCP standard. That essentially just overclocks your RAM. And like I said, if you're not going to tournaments and stuff like that, I would really try to learn how to overclock like safely in your BIOS. If you're going, like if you're a competitor like me and you watch this, then this should be good for when you go to LAN. A lot of these settings hopefully will be applied for Worlds, so we won't even have to do this. But yeah, I think that's everything that I can think of. Now I'm gonna attempt to play the game. I haven't played in a few days, so I'll see you guys on the other side.